Russell Smith with Holiday World of Houston. I run RV Trader here. Y'all might have seen some of my videos. This is gonna be one of the best ones. Why a 2005, you might ask? Isn't that 10 years old? Yeah, it is. Well, it's 9 years old, but it'll be 10 years old here pretty soon. There's a reason that we do 2005s on here, and it's only whenever we get the peaches in. And this is one of our peaches. You're not gonna find another 2005 in this condition anywhere. One owner. It's a Fleetwood Flair 31A. I guess I should mention that too. 31A, we've got it retail priced at 45 grand, but we've got it marked down on the internet, and you can see it there on RV Trader at the markdown price. It's a 32 footer, right at 32 feet. Really clean, one owner, always stored in an enclosed storage. So it's been really well taken care of. The previous owners actually traded it in for a toy hauler. That's the direction they wanted to go. But you're not gonna find a nicer one at this price. Come on, let me show you around. All right, one of the things that people liked about the Flair whenever Fleetwood was doing it was the way they have the storage set up. So you've got storage under here. You've got storage right here. You've got storage right here, and it's all pass-through. So you're not gonna intrude on anything. You're not gonna have anything intrude on you if you've got something long you need to store. It's a nice feature on them. Right back here, you've got the generator. The nice thing about this generator is it's not just the standard Onan. Now, most of y'all know Onan, that's the Cummins brand. It's a great generator. People put 3,000 hours on them all the time. No problems. This one isn't just the standard Onan, it's the Marquee Gold. It's a 5.5. The Marquee Gold is a step up from the standard. It's actually two steps up from the standard one. But this one gives you a quieter generator whenever it's running. And it's also a lot less vibration on it. One of the things that they do, you can actually put a nickel on top of it whenever it's running, and the nickel won't move, standing on its side. Back here, you've got your convenience center. You'll see all your hoses, all your hookups, everything. It's all conveniently located right here. And then you've got your electrical hookup right here. All right, around the back here, you're gonna notice there's a 5,000 pound hitch back here. Yeah, it sits on a 21,000 pound chassis. It's a workhorse chassis again. But anyways, you've got your hitch right here. As you can tell underneath, there's no real signs of rust. I mean, it doesn't look like they took it to the beach or took it up north a whole lot. It really stayed in a very, very sterile environment most of its life. Gas tank fills up right here. You can tell the back cap's still in great shape. You've got your ladder. You can mount the roof right here. And there's gonna be, the rest of it will be right in one of these storage compartments. I'll show you that in just a second. First thing I wanna show you is whenever I do my videos, I don't just want to point out the good things on it. I want to point out the hickeys and stuff. That way you know exactly what you're getting into whenever you come by. You'll see the decals right here. They have some scratches in them. I want to point that out. And then it has a little bit of road rash. It looks like they might have sideswiped something just barely right here. And I don't know if you can see it. But if you need more information, just call me. I'll tell you more about it. I'll send you some close-up pictures. But it's that big. It's just a surface scrape. It's not all the way to the fiberglass, but it's there. And then you've got these guys right here. So that's something I would want to point out. I would want you to know that before you came in and took a closer look at it before you put that next up. But again, in the grand scheme of things, that's pretty benign. Storage. You can see your ladder right there. Right here, more storage. This is a quick connect for your gas line right there. Let me make sure that's closed. Outdoor entertainment center. You've got your radio right here. You've got speakers outside, and you've got speaker jacks here as well. So if you want to watch, if you want to play the music while you're hanging out outside, you can do that. And actually, there's a TV here too. So if you want to watch TV while you're outside, you can do that as well. There's a 110 outlet in that bay also. So if you need to plug anything else in, you got that option. Of course, you got all your appliances right here, fridge, your furnace, your hot water heater, whichever way they are. You've got one water input right there. And then if you check out the handle, you can tell this thing's been upgraded whenever they bought it. The handle, it's got the LED lights running through it. So it lights up whenever it's flipped on. It's a beautiful feature. I'd show you, but it wouldn't show up in the middle of the day in Texas. Then finally, the very front here, you're gonna have your LP tank right here at the bottom with easy with your easy valve right there to put more LP in there, more propane in there. And you have a little bit of storage above it. You know, it's not much, but every little bit you can get, if you've been camping before, you know, every little bit you can get helps. Like I said earlier, this is a clean coach. It was used properly. Only has 28,000 miles on it. After 9 years, that's a pretty good accomplishment. Took really good care of it. You'll see the workhorse chassis. They put a steering wheel cover on it. Take a little bit better care of it. But if you look at the seats, these flex steel seats are still in fantastic shape. You just can't beat it. Of course, they both swivel. So if you want to turn them around, face the rest of the crew, or the rest of the cabin rather, you're good to go. You'll notice power mirrors over on the left-hand side where the armrest is. And then above that, you've got an Atwood hydraulic leveling system. So you just push up a button, you can level it out. Up there, you've got storage. They added a Toshiba flat screen TV. Right under the flat screen TV, you'll notice the rear view camera that was added afterwards. And then whenever you go more to the right, that'll contain your switch box for your cable, your VCR, your TV, all that good stuff. And then underneath that, they've got a DVD VCR player. Going down to that chair, you'll notice how good a shape that chair is in as well. They're both in great shape. And then finally, that Onan generator I was telling you about, it only has 453 hours on it. Again, it looks like they never even used these seats. Sofa, green, popular color in 2005. Leather, it's flex steel. Again, you're gonna hear flex steel a lot. There's a lot of upgraded equipment in here. You've got a flex steel leather couch. Whenever you have somebody staying with you, just that right there, there's a little latch right there. You pull the lock, pull it out, it'll make your bed real easy. Dinette over here does a bed as well. You've got nice treatments up here, residential quality hinges with the shocks. And you'll notice, whenever I'm going around here, you're gonna notice how much storage is in the Fleetwood. Three burner stove, oven, Samsung microwave, stainless steel sink, Moen faucet, Brita filter. You've got one of your control panels right here. This is your tank levels, your battery disconnects, hot water heater, water pump, things of that nature is right there. And then you're gonna come over here, there's a pantry with all maintenance records, all your manuals, everything's right there. Drawers underneath for more storage. Again, storage, storage, storage. More storage right here. And then on top of that, you get your Dometic two-way fridge. Works on gas, works on electric, either one, and you've got an automatic control. Your slide-out controls are gonna be right up here, right above the front door. And then right down here, you're gonna have all your step lights and your entryway lights. All right, we're in the bathroom right now. This is the next area past the living area. You'll notice medicine cabinet, nice vanity up here. Everything's brass, which is amazing for a Fleetwood Flair. You've got your sink here. Neo angle shower with detachable shower head. You have all your lights for your lavatory, your bathroom in general. And then we're gonna go into the toilet right here. The head has a flush, convenient access to your toilet paper, storage above, so you have plenty of places to put anything you might want. And then at the very top, you'll notice a fantastic fan. One thing I didn't point out in the living room, it has a fantastic fan in there too. So you got two fantastic fans in here. If I haven't said fantastic fan enough, I'll say it one more time. Fantastic fans are fantastic. We're going back to the bedroom right now. You're gonna notice there's a queen bed right here. You got your window treatments right above it. And I didn't get to say this, but you actually have nightshades all the way around. You got storage above that. Reading lamps on either side. You'll notice the threshold still looks good. You got storage above it. Right over here, they've actually redone the TV in here as well. So you've got a Toshiba in here. You got a Toshiba up in the front. We're just Toshiba'd out. But it is a flat screen. It is, the way they've mounted it, it does come off. I don't want to break it right now. But you've also got storage right behind here. Roll-up desk where you can do your work, any work you might need to do. You got your AC controls here. You do have two ACs in here. So you've got both ACs, one in the rear, one in the front. You can control them both from right here in the bedroom. All your lights and everything are right here. You've got 110 outlets. One thing I didn't go over on the bed also has 110 outlets on either side. Anybody with a CPAP machine, you can hook up and not worry about it. You can charge your phone, anything you might need. And then finally, the coup de grace, the wardrobe is amazing. Look at that. You RVers, you know what I'm talking about. That's huge. It's big for a 31 footer. I don't know of many wardrobes, of many dressers that give you this much space and this short of a coach. And then underneath, you'll see all the drawers you might have for your foldables. All right, again, my name is Russell Smith. If you're gonna have more questions about it, just call me, or you can come in and look at it yourself. One thing I did forget to mention is the awning is in great shape. Didn't get a chance to show you that, but it's a manual awning, so there's less to go wrong as you go down your travels. Whenever you come in, see me. You can reach me at the number listed directly above your screen right here. The promo code to get this special internet pricing is RSF. I also run one of the websites here, so if you're on that website, you can see that directly here on the website, and I'll give you the RV trader price no matter what. So you can reach me directly at that number listed above. If you have any other questions, call me. I'd love to help you out.